In this video, I'm going to do an example where we're going to put it all together. So if you're given a point on a line and its slope, we're going to write the equation. You should be able to do that in both standard and in slope-intercept form using any of the methods we've gone over. Be able to state the x and y intercepts, be able to graph it, be able to check that that is the correct line, the equations of the line are correct, and as well as the graph. So here's an example. Write the equation of the line passing through negative 2n with slope of 3/4 in standard form. Also state the x-intercept, y-intercept, and graph the line. Now, if we know the slope and the y-intercept, we'll also be able to write it in the slope-intercept form. Since we're looking for standard form, I'm going to use the slope point formula since we're given a slope and a point. So I have, remember, the formula, y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. And we will be plugging in 3/4 for the slope. And for the x1, we'll put in the x-coordinate of our point, which is negative 2. And for y1, we'll be putting in the y-coordinate. So we have y minus 1 equals 3/4 x. Now I'm going to have x minus negative 2, so that'll end up being x plus 2. Hopefully you're okay with that. Now since I'm asked to put this in standard form, instead of solving for y, I'm going to eliminate the fractions for my first step. Since there's a fraction 3/4, the denominator is 4, I'm going to multiply both sides of the equation by 4. So let's multiply both sides of the equation by 4. Now on the left hand side, remember, you're going to have to multiply the whole side, y minus 1 times 4, and that gives me 4y minus 4. And on the right side, when I multiply it, the 4 is going to cancel with the denominator of 4, so I won't need to distribute it because it will already cancel. So that 4 cancels, so that I really have 3 times x plus 2. So if you have fractions, what you can do is multiply by the least common denominator first, and then you won't have any fractions. Now I'm trying to put this in standard form, so I'm going to put the x and y term on the left hand side, so I'm going to subtract 3x from both sides, negative 3x plus 4y, and I'm going to add 4 to both sides. So I've put this equation in standard form, and remember, you can also multiply both sides by negative 1 so that the first term is positive and write it as 3x minus 4y equals negative 10. Both of these are correct. I'm going to just write this as the answer in standard form. All right, so far we've got the equation in standard form. Now, what else was I asked to get? The x-intercept, the y-intercept, and graph the line. All right, now getting the x and y-intercept, standard form is useful for getting the x and y-intercept because it's easy to plug in 0 for x and 0 for y. So for the x-intercept, remember we put in 0 for the y, and for the y-intercept, we put in the 0 for the x. All right, so if I put in 0 for y into this standard form, I get 3x is negative 10. So x is negative 10 thirds. I'm going to write that as negative 3 and 1 third. All right, now I have to put in 0 for x. So that gives you negative 4y equals negative 10. So divided by negative 4, I get y equals 5 halves, which is 2.5. All right, so I've got the equation of the line in standard form. Now I also know the x-intercept and the y-intercept, right? Last thing is to graph it. All right, so here's the information we were given. We were given that it goes through the point negative 2, 1, so we still know that. We also were given that the slope was 3/4. By using the point slope formula, we got that 3x minus 4y equals negative 10 was the standard form. We found out the x-intercept was negative 3 and 1/3, 0. We found out the y-intercept was 0, 2, and a half. By the way, since I know the slope and the y-intercept, I know the slope-intercept form is y equals 3/4 x plus 2 and a half or 5 halves, either way you want to write it. So that is the slope-intercept method. I'm sorry, slope-intercept form, which we weren't asked for, but we could write it down. So let's see, if I wanted to graph this, I know that negative 2, 1 was given. So if I want, I could just start off by putting that ordered pair there, and then I could use the slope to find some more points, right? So I can do the rise over the ren. The ren's 4, is 4 to the right and 3 down. Okay, so there's one way of getting another point. I also know it goes through negative 1/3, 3 and 1/3. Oops, I went down 3. I meant to go up 3. Let's do that again. So I've got that that's why it's nice to have all this information. It's easier to find your mistakes. So I'm going 4 to the right and 3 up. There we go. All right. So I also know that it goes through negative 3 and 1/3, 0. Let's see. Does it look like this line's going to go through there? Yeah, it does. Look at, there's like negative 3 and 1/3, 0 about right here. It also says it goes through 0, 2 and a half. Well, that seems to agree. Do you see how these all are lining up just nicely? So connecting the dots, you're going to get the graph of the line. The one thing we didn't do, this looks like it's all worked out just nicely, is we do want to make sure that this ordered pair, negative 2, 1, is on the line that we stated was the equation, 3x minus 4y. So let's just double check that. That would be the last thing I'd want to make sure of. Is that on 3x minus 4y is negative 10? So we're just going to put in negative 2 for x and 1 for y and make sure that's a true statement. That gives you negative 6 minus 4 equals negative 10. Yeah, it checks out. So I did all that. So what I'm trying to show you is that, you know, there's a lot of ways to find out a lot of things about the line. So if I'm given this ordered pair and the slope, I was able to write the equation of the line in standard form. I was able to write the equation of the line in slope-intercept form. Because it was in standard form, it was easy to write the x-intercept and y-intercept. It was easy to check that order pair was on the equation that I said was the answer, the 3x minus 4y equals negative 10. It was easy to graph the line and make sure all these points really lined up, etc. So what I want you to look for are all the connections. And of course, I could have solved the original equation differently. And that's the last thing I'm going to do for any of you who are interested. What if you wanted to solve this equation by solving for B and putting it in slope-intercept form instead of standard form? So stay tuned. We're going to do that now. Negative 2, 1, and 3/4. All right, so we want the equation of the line passing through negative 2, 1, and 3/4. And let's put it slope-intercept form and do it by solving for b. That was the very first method I went over. So we take the equation y equals mx plus b. And remember, we're going to plug in 3/4 for the slope. We're going to plug in negative 2 for the x and 1 for the y. So I have 1 equals 3/4 times negative 2 plus b. 1 equals, all right, it's going to be negative, and I can cancel. So what I have, negative 3 halves plus b. And then I have to add 3 halves to both sides. So I'm going to write 1 as 2 halves. 2 halves plus 3 halves is b, so I have that b is 5 halves. So I know the slope is 3/4. I've got b is 5 halves. So the equation of the line and slope-intercept is y equals 3/4 x plus 5 halves, which agrees with what we just did earlier. Remember? Read out the slope-intercept form because we had found out the y-intercept by taking the equation of the line in standard form, putting in 0 for x. We also got it that way. Lots and lots of connections. So that's sort of a comprehensive example. If you know a point on the line and the slope, we were able to put it in standard form, find the x-intercept, find the y-intercept, put it in slope-intercept form, graph it, check it, do it this completely different way, getting the equation of the line, etc. So keep practicing.